Roundtable Talk with your favorite three. I am LaMaya Perlina.
I'm Anthony Peterson.
And it's your girl, Tony Hall.
And we back, y'all. I know y'all missed us.
We're back. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited to be back in the good old presence of Hilliard Hall in this freezing studio. Tony,
how was y'all's week been?
It's been good. Just been
going.
What
you been doing?
I ain't been doing nothing.
We ain't talked to you in a whole 2 weeks. Where you been?
I've been living.
Doing what?
Doing what I do.
What do ants do? What did you do? We're trying to catch up. We want to know what's up.
I've been doing work. Been playing the game. Doing everything.
Anthony, why you been texting? Like 2 weeks.
No,
I want to know, like, what was going on? Were you just
finally
putting it on
blast?
Ignoring me.
Oh, no.
And Tony.
Really?
My phone was broke.
We were texting Anthony back to back, calling him everything, and we talked to his friends, and he was not talking to us.
No, y'all didn't call me.
Where he was.
Y'all just called me.
No.
Today.
Y'all just called me.
No. Called you last night.
Tony, what have you been doing all week?
Girl, first off, I was in D.C. last week. It was amazing. It was cold, but it's
colder than in here right now?
No, man, it, like, matched it, actually. I would probably say it matched it. Like, it was really cold up there. It was great. I was at the Thurgood Marshall Leadership Institute. Mm-hmm. It was really good. Out of, I think they said, like, 2,000 applications, 800 got interviews, 400 actually got flown out to D.C. I was really appreciative of that. And I had the opportunity to be a ambassador for Thurgood Marshall, so I was able to work their social medias and, like, post stuff.
What you over there tweeting?
You know, I was just, you know, doing what Tonys do.
What do Tonys do? Wow.
Chill. But I was so blessed. I also had the opportunity to interview with the NBA. It was
really
I got that opportunity. What was that about?
Man, it was spectacular. So basically, they just wanted to get to know some of the candidates that were, like, mass comm majors that were there. There was only, like, a handful of us. But they liked me. They wanted me to apply for an internship, so I did that. So now I'm just at standby.
They were at the convention.
Yeah, they were.
The Marshall?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah. That's beautiful.
What about you?
LaMaya's, honey. There's only one. And that's me. And I have been doing amazing things. Just so you guys know, I'll be hosting a fashion show / art gallery / networking event called The Art of the Industry this Sunday on the 11th at 7 o'clock. If you go on my Instagram, click the link in my bio. You can get your tickets. It already sold about, like, 200 tickets, I think. And, yeah, I'm getting paid to do it. Girl, they're making me a new wig.
What? Mm-hmm. So that's wig number five. Number five.
Yeah, so I'll be doing that as well as next on the 18th, next week.
Mm-hmm.
Next week on the 18th, I will be having I co-host another show called Musicville, where it's a platform show aired on TV, live audience, and we support and platform up-and-coming artists. I'm also looking for models, so DM me on Instagram or Twitter. And also artists, singers, rappers, poets. I'm looking for those as well, so we can get to working and getting y'all some clout.
So that's what LaMaya does.
That's what LaMaya does.
But listen, you know how straightforward she was with that? You know, we didn't have to, like, do loopholes. Like, we had to do you.
Oh, I ain't do no loopholes. I you do know, what I do.
You know, I just feel like you was ignoring us.
Really? Yeah. Gonna hashtag hurt.
Hashtag her. Well, these are the up and coming events going on right now.
Yes.
Let's start with Madea, Tyler Perry.
Yes.
Ooh,
you know
Madea.
Anything about that?
Madea gone.
Madea's about to die.
Is she really?
Yes. He looks so serious. I was watching an interview. I forgot who he was interviewing with or who Tyler Perry was interviewing with, but basically he was talking about, yeah, he's done with Madea. And I understand. I mean, Madea's been around for a long
time. Madea was old when she came out. She had
Madea's been around for a minute. Like, I'm talking my childhood, like, since I was maybe, what, 5, 6 years old?
How old is Madea? Not how old the character is. How old is Madea?
Well, I don't know.
We don't know. Madea is one of those people in your life. They've been old. They was born old. Like Morgan Freeman.
Morgan Freeman.
He's been old.
I don't know.
But my thing is, with the trailer, though, it didn't seem like Madea was dying. The trailer, however, there's a father in someone's family who dies, and Madea is planning the funeral. But this will be the last Tyler Perry
movie
production with Madea.
Yes.
So wait, no more plays?
Madea's planning the funeral. Maybe she's going to die at the end. We don't know. Maybe she's going to have a heart attack or something.
Bro,
we do not know.
She got to go out with a bang. But if you don't take Madea away from us, she better go out with
Tyler Perry said he had already filmed this about 2 years, allegedly 2 years ago. So.
Allegedly.
Wow. He's been filming 2 years ago. Okay, let's talk about PB.
Yes.
What's going on? PV, MSC, what's going on?
Oh, my gosh. Okay, so today around 12 o'clock-ish, the alarms went off in the whole entire MSC.
Oh, no.
So everybody, it was a mandatory evacuation out of the MSC. We were all confused. Like, I had just sat down. I had got my food. Girl, I had made a little nice little salad. I was like, it's about to go hard. And they're like, everyone, y'all got to get out. Y'all got to go. Y'all got to go. And we like, what's going on? Like, we don't even know what's going on. He was like, bro, y'all just gotta go. Y'all gotta leave. Bro, the Sodexo.
So what ended up happening?
They said it was a fire alarm. And today is Wednesday. And if you know anything about Prairie View, Wednesday is probably the busiest day of the week because it's hump day.
You know what I think? They allegedly pulled a fire alarm because people were trying to protest them do rags, and Sodexo isn't having it. PV, MSC isn't having it. So later last week, there was a enforcement of dress policy in the MSC where they're not allowing any type of do rags, hats, midriff shirts, et cetera, to be allowed into the cafeteria area. If you are wearing that, you will not be served.
Exactly.
And PB Twitter went rampant. There was a flyer that said, ain't no do-rags, bitch. Ain't no dress code, bitch, and they're wearing do-rags in protest. So maybe that's what happened.
I just hope those people that were protesting went out and voted. Just throwing that out there.
I don't like that, though. Why we gotta be suited up just to go get something to eat?
Man, I don't know. In my opinion, I understand they don't want, you know, especially girls that go in there showing all their goods and stuff. They don't want people to see that anymore.
Not necessarily as far as that, because if you dress inappropriately, that's one thing.
Yeah,
but
I think it's that.
I feel like some people go in there just to eat, and they gonna go about their day or something like that. Mm-hmm. So I don't feel like you should always have to be dressed a certain way just to go get something to eat.
I think that I tweeted on Twitter. I engaged in this PB Twitter nonsense last night, I don't really do Twitter. I do not like it.
First time.
But I had said that the MSC should have encouraged well-dressed and modest dress rather than enforcing it. But then again, PB student needs to realize that we are at a university and not a community center, not a rec center, not a party.
Yeah.
So when you're coming and you're representing yourself in such a way that no one's going to take you seriously, that's a problem. But we are eating. Do you get into a suit when you're at the dinner table at your own home?
Not at all.
Sometimes. When I'm feeling it. You remember this one girl said?
What?
This one girl said we shouldn't have a dress code if they serving stuff like honey,
honey barbecue chicken nuggets stir fry.
What is that?
I said that is a struggle food where you ain't got nothing in your kitchen. You just putting stuff together to make it through the day. But we gotta go to break.
Already?
Well, we'll be back with the round table talk.
With the honey barbecue chicken nuggets.
We need you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
We rely on your support to help us with our motto. All out, all game, all season. Your contribution is the home run we need.
We need you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
I'm Vernon Bland, former student athlete and baseball Hall of Famer. I now have the honor of serving as a softball coach at our alma mater. We charge our student athletes every day to strive for excellence, and they have met the challenge. Now it's your turn.
We need you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
Hey, Panther Nation, it's Coach Tacho Tyler, two-time Hall of Famer and current head volleyball coach here, and we need you guys to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
We need you. Support the Panther Excellence Fund.
As a 12-time champion, as a former student athlete, assistant coach, now head coach, I've witnessed firsthand how teamwork creates success. We need your support to help propel us to new heights.
Hi, I'm Eric Dooley, Prairie View new head football coach. Prairie View Panthers has a historic tradition of academics and athletic success. Panther Nation, it's time to focus on the acronym WIN. What's important now? And what's important now is each of you to join and support the Panther Excellence Fund.
Your gift is vital to help us achieve our goal on the hill. Help us win today by sending in your contribution.
Dr. Joshua Muhammad. And he is coming to talk to us about Election Day that happened yesterday, November 6, 2018, as well as the march that was held here on our campus of Prairie View A&M University. If you guys aren't aware, Prairie View and some organizations on campus conducted a march, hosted a march, which led to hundreds of students filling the streets of our campus, not protesting, but encouraging our peers to march and to vote for the midterm elections. And how are you doing?
I'm doing well. How about you?
I'm doing fabulous.
What an intro.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you. I've been practicing. Anywho, back to this. So basically, I really want to talk to you about what inspired this march that happened yesterday.
Okay, so it's a long story, but I'm going to do my best to make it short. Over the past, mostly October, there's been a struggle for against voter suppression and against Waller County for Prairie View. We didn't get any voting days the first week of early voting. There's 2 weeks of early voting. We got no voting days the first week, which is disparity compared to other sections or cities in Waller County, especially considering our large voter population, that one in every seven person that's registered to vote in Waller County is a Prairie View student. So it makes no sense that smaller cities were getting days the first week, but we got none for the first week. So as a response to that, we began pushing students to the polls. We did a lot of different activities and political engagement. And then for the march specifically, it was first organized a call for by a community member by the name of Dwayne Charleston, and also one of the primary organizers' name was Jessica Purnell. And they pulled me in as well as some of my friends, Madrian Lowe, Kirsten Budwine. It's a list of them that came together and organized the march, really to show Prairie View students our power and what we're accomplished of, what we're able to accomplish, and then say, okay, this is time for us to show up and show out when it comes to the elections.
Okay, and so how do you feel like it went? What was the outcome? I mean, y'all, we made it.
It was good.
So the show was, people coming out for the march was very good. I don't know the number that was on there, but it was a lot of people. Cause I was one of the speakers there. We had Senator Royce Rest came down, Boris Miles. We had a man by the name of Craig Washington who organized one of the first marches and had a lawsuit back in, I think either the 70s or 60s. So it was a very good display. And even when it comes to the voting numbers, I believe in our precinct 309, which is the university, we had about 1,500 to 1,600 students that went up and went to the polls. So it was a success in my eyes.
That's good, because I don't feel like people have voted here. I remember the last presidential election, people didn't vote because they knew that Hillary Clinton was going to win.
Yeah, and
people do that.
Yeah, it was a lot with the Hillary Clinton thing. I don't think it was all to blame on the people per se. I also think that Hillary Clinton also had like a sense of entitlement. She felt like, my husband was the president, so it's like my time now. And it really underestimated how much racism is rampant in this country.
Yeah.
That somebody like Trump could do that and then become the president.
Somebody like Trump, who has no experience in any type of Congress, any type of presidential positions, anything. This man probably thought it was a joke too.
I'm in the room when he like won. Was he like, oh, bro, they took me serious.
He probably knew he was gonna win. I know. I learned in history class, actually. If you don't know anything about either voter, the person you hear about more is who you more likely to vote for.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I agree. So with the outcome, with one thing that one person I think that a lot of us were pushing for was Beto, and he didn't win.
He didn't.
How do you feel?
I'm not surprised, and I wasn't really too pressed about him losing, especially as a black person. We understand the history of us in America, especially in politics. We are Democratic by default. We don't like Republicans, so we kind of just ride with Democrats. And if a likable white dude or a likable black person comes up and we like throw 80% plus of our vote behind them, but we end up always on the losing end because we never actually set forth an agenda that we hold them accountable to. So Beto, he's a cool dude. He probably meant well and everything. But just because he's a likable dude, if you don't have an agenda as a people by which to force politicians to engage with your agenda, it doesn't matter who's in office. Could be a Beto or a Bernie or a Trump or whatever have you. You're still going to end up losing.
So can I ask you this? Where did this passion for government come from? Because when you speak,
you know it.
I'm educated over here.
Well,
where did this passion come from?
I gotta give all praise to God and truly my upbringing. So my name is Joshua Muhammad. I'm a member of the nation, so under Minister Louis Farrakhan, so think of the Malcolm X's, the Muhammad Ali's. So I just have a love for black people. And anything that intersects with my love for black people that could lead to our liberation and our struggle, then I'm fully engaged in that. And I grew up in Houston. Houston has a very strong black activist community, and I grew up watching my mentors in the struggle for justice in Houston in black activism, and it just sort of got passed to me.
And it's not crazy because I notice it in South Dallas. South Dallas is the hood.
Like, yes.
You know for sure it's the hood. But when you go around the mosque, it's a little bit different. It feels a little bit different. Because it's like...
We've always been a pillar in the black community ever since the 30s. And although a lot of people have a lot of things to say about us, when you look at the track record of the Nation of Islam and our work at reforming black people, it's like, it's really... I would say second to none in a lot of areas, and that's why I love it.
They do a lot of work in the community.
Yeah, a lot of work in the community, so that's where my passion came from, to answer your question.
When you hear that over 90% of black women voted for Beto and more of the minorities voted for Beto, but we're still in a red state, how does that make you feel?
Again, I would say it doesn't surprise me because I know Texas. In the 80s, Texas actually used to be Democratic. And all the people, they used to be what's called yellow dog Democrats. And they were people that they say they'll never vote Republican ever. And then once black people started getting the Democratic Party, they switched over to being Republican. So it doesn't surprise me how deep-rooted it is, but I know it's always going to be a struggle anytime we're trying to push any type of agenda that's not a conservative agenda in Texas.
Regardless of Democrat or Republican, what do you feel is the best way to go through change?
I feel the best way to go through change, I'm gonna speak for black people, is to devise an unapologetic black agenda. You can look at every demographic, whether it's white people, Chinese people, LGBT community, and you can pretty much have an understanding of what they want. When you ask black people what we want is give us a job and stop killing us. It's really not a mature, well-thought-out agenda that when somebody comes to engage us, asks for our vote or our support, they say, okay, I'm gonna give you my support, but you gotta meet these 10 points right here. And I think that's the best way, the best start to engage in change. And really, it's not going to come from a person that's in an office somewhere. It's going to start with us going inside our own communities, lifting them up, making them safe and decent places to live, and then from there have a foundation to put that agenda on.
So that was really good, by the way.
Thank
I felt
you.
Like I should have took some notes right there.
Oh. Good one, y'all.
So
you
went
on a roll today.
Girl, what? Man, so how do you, not really how do you, but do you plan on trying to make change happen? Like, how do you plan on getting your voice out even more? Because like we said, you're very educated.
Thank you.
You're very educated. So how do you plan on you making an impact, basically?
It's something I've been doing. Like, I started in Houston, and I brought my passion to PV, and PV has been, like, even more of a training ground to me. And so when I leave Prairie View, I'm going to still have roots in Prairie View. I started an organization I'm leaving behind called the Panther Party that started after the injustice of Sandra Bland, and I want that to continue on in Prairie View. But even more so, when I go back to Houston, I'm going to still be engaged in activism. I'm looking to start my own profit and various other things. So that's the future, God willing, for Joshua Muhammad.
That's awesome.
What?
That's awesome.
That's beautiful.
What? Thank you.
I really
are amazing.
Y'all gonna make me blush. You can't see it, but y'all gonna make me blush.
We thank you for coming. No problem.
Thank you.
You said so many things that I hope you guys at home, at school, in the library, wherever you are listening, take some notes down. You can always rewind and listen to what he said.
Yeah,
also, I just want to... Yeah, we're on YouTube. I do want to pinpoint out that there are 100 women who just got elected to Congress,
yes.
19 black women who are in Harris County,
yes.
who are judges now, and I think we had so many firsts this election. Mm-hmm. First LGBT candidate. We have our first Muslim, and she's a Somali American congresswoman in Minnesota. That's my state. And I just commend every single one of you. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
We gotta go on break. We'll be right back.
Yes.
We need you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
We rely on your support to help us with our motto: all out, all game, all season. Your contribution is the home run we need
you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
I'm Vernon Bland, former student athlete and baseball Hall of Famer. I now have the honor of serving as a softball coach at our alma mater. We charge our student athletes every day to strive for excellence, and they have met the challenge. Now it's your turn.
We need you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
Hey, Panther Nation, it's Coach Tacho Tyler, 2-time Hall of Famer and current head volleyball coach here, and we need you guys to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
We need you. Support the Panther Excellence Fund.
As a 12-time champion, as a former student athlete, assistant coach, now head coach, I've witnessed firsthand how teamwork creates success. We need your support to help propel us to new heights.
Hi, I'm Eric Dooley, Prairie View new head football coach. Prairie View Panthers have a historic tradition of academics and athletic success. Panther Nation, it's time to focus on the acronym WIN. What's important now? And what's important now is each of you to join and support the Panther Excellence Fund.
Your gift is vital to help us achieve our goal on the hill. Help us win today by sending in your contribution.
And we back. It's been a good episode. Like, you didn't tell me my microphone was jacked up.
I was staring at your eyes. I wasn't really paying attention to your
show. Everybody in America. Everybody in the whole world. So I can't even get a microphone. This week, what's coming up?
Next week. I can't with them no more. We have Charlemagne the God. He's going to be here at Prairie View November 17th.
Yeah.
And he's going to be talking about his new book he released. He's going to be doing a couple of press talks, things like that. We also, the same day, we play, is it Alabama A&M? Alabama State? One of them Alabama schools.
Football. Let's get it.
Was this our second, third home game this year?
Yeah.
Play one of those Alabama
schools. They're exhausted. They're all sad. They're giving up hope. Football team, please keep your head up. If you need to call me, call me. Don't call me. I'm just playing. Anywho, so next
next week we will be talking about studying abroad.
Yes.
So next week, study abroad, they're going to come in, kind of give us a little debrief of what studying abroad is and what it looks like. I'm excited for that because I put an application to study abroad. Your girl's trying to go to Costa Rica, baby.
Oh.
So hopefully that happens.
If you could study abroad, where would you go?
If I could study abroad, I would go to either France. I would go to
Jamaica?
Jamaica.
Is that studying abroad?
That is studying abroad.
Yeah, I would go to Jamaica. I would go to France, and I would go to China.
Wow. That sounds nice.
I want to get culture.
That's kind of a round trip.
Yeah, I would go to this place. Where would you go?
You?
No. Probably Canada. I
knew you were gonna say that. I was
somewhere like Canada.
Don't say something nearby.
I go to Africa.
I go to Africa.
If I wasn't so scared of animals, I'd go to the safari. But as soon as I see something, man, I see a mosquito too big.
Bro, you know they got hissing roaches.
How big are they?
Bro, them things are big.
They be hissing,
and they fly too. Hissing and they fly.
Yo, I seen a flying roach. Never mind, I ain't gonna tell y'all where. Ain't at my house. What was that?
FPV. Yeah.
I ain't gonna tell y'all.
If you wanna see something you can't get at, look on the PV.
Have you seen him on the
They're
armadillos. Are they possums?
Oh no.
They look like dogs. They have these animals.
Can we talk about it? This nightlife here at PV, these animals. Not that nightlife.
Them PV cats. Them PV cats are drugs.
Oh, no cats. I used to feed the cats when I used to live in the phases, and the cats used to sit
there.
Yeah.
She's one of them.
The cat whisperer. I did! And then in the mornings, I would go to work, and the cats would be sitting on my car, on my truck.
Oh, no.
That cat woman right there in the flesh, Miss Lamaya.
What is going on for the rest of this, you said this week, is there any events? No?
Not.
I guess not.
You don't have anything going on?
No.
You have anything going on?
It's Alpha Week.
No, there's no Shave November. Oh, no disrespect.
No,
that's no Shave November. I've been thugging it out since. October. But it's
Alpha Week. It's Alpha Week. So if you guys want to go participate in some of the Alpha Weeks, Instagram has the event poster.
It's also Ski Week.
Yes. So
come on out. We have events. Ski Week, it's my sorority, so we have a week long full of events tonight. We have an event in the rec. It's Get Fit with the AKAs. I might not be there, but hey.
Can guys go too?
Everybody can come.
Okay.
Guys, we gotta wrap the show up. We wanna thank you guys so much. We wanna say thanks to Mr. Muhammad for coming in and just giving us a rundown of this world. Thank you for that.
You kept it real.
100. I'm Tony Hall.
I'm Anthony Peterson.
I'm Vila Maya Felina.
Bye, y'all. It's the round.
See y'all next week.